Imagine the paintings great artists like Rembrandt would have created if they had lived longer. Or just ask a computer. For 2 years, a group of researchers, computer scientists, and art historians have been working on a project called the Next Rembrandt. The goal? To use computers to create a new painting in the style of the 17th century Dutch master. First, the project team gathered data. They decided that their target painting was a portrait of a Caucasian man with facial hair, age 30 to 40, wearing a hat, black clothes, and a white collar. They concentrated their research on all the paintings Rembrandt did with those elements and used 3D scanners to get detailed measurements of the paintings. The team developed computer programs that analyzed the paintings. They were able to define how Rembrandt would paint features like an eye or a nose by studying dozens of examples. These points of data became a roadmap for the new painting. In a way, the team had created a sort of puzzle. Each feature became a piece, and then the team had to fit the pieces together. They used computer algorithms that measured how Rembrandt would space features apart from one another. How close or far apart are the eyes? How did Rembrandt space them from the nose? They used the answers to plot out the new painting. And the team didn't stop there. Paintings may look flat, but they are actually three-dimensional. Canvas has a texture, as do brush strokes. The team used detailed scans of Rembrandt's work to study his technique and replicate it in the computer model. The result was a painting that didn't just resemble Rembrandt's style, it replicated it down to the brush strokes. But how does a computer paint a portrait? The answer is in 3D printing. The printer used a special paint-based UV ink to create the new work. It laid down the portrait layer by layer. The result is a work that looks an awful lot like a Rembrandt painting. This is a pretty cool project. The team didn't replicate a specific masterpiece, they created a new work by replicating a style. Imagine a future in which computers can do this with other art. We could finally discover what happens in Love's Labor's One. Granted, even with this impressive display, you could argue the computer isn't really an artist. It's incorporating prevalent stylistic elements to create new work, but there's no spark of genius deep inside the computer mind. Until computers can actually express themselves, which will first require they have something to express, they'll never reach the status of master artist. So, what do you think? Will our future artists be robots? What is AI's place in art? Get in touch and let us know. And make sure you visit now.howstuffworks.com every day to hear about the coolest stories going on right now.